Good afternoon. My name's Cy Curnin from the Fixx, and I just popped in to say hello. The wonder of wings and hands and what you can do with them. And they asked me to play my favourite video of ours. I've picked one called Precious Stone, not because it's my favourite, it's because I haven't seen it in its finished form. Well, I have seen it once when I was in it. So I wanted to have another look at it, and this is it. It's called Precious Stone. Take it away.
Welcome.
Thank you. That was a good wig. Whatever happened to that wig?
Interesting. You know, I was mentioning to you during the video and previously that I very much enjoyed this new album that you have. It's called Ink, I understand.
Yeah, Ink.
And the reason why I like it so much, partly, is because the songs that you have seem very simple, but the words really hit. They make sense. You hear the song and you go, oh, I think I understand what this person is all about.
Right.
So are you sort of exposing who you are in these songs?
Yeah, a little bit. You know, it's the more songs you write, then you know, you realize that it's all introspective, really. It's you look at the world inside out or outside in, but it's how you see things. It's not necessarily the way it is. It's all, everything is illusionary. So writing lyrics can be fun if you learn to hide your character, you know, between certain lines. And wear your heart in the sleeve, as they say.
Mm-hmm.
It fell off.
Interesting. Now, your record company said that one of the important things about the Fixx is that there's a willingness to change with the times.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm wondering how this new material is indicative of 1991.
Well, having been through the 80s, I'm sure as everybody else has been, you know, everything was buy, 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 and everybody, you feel inadequate unless you had the latest gadget. And then you come out of the 80s and you think, well, what the hell was all that about? CDs up the wazoo, this, that, you know, TVs, and it just drives you mad. And in the end, you miss the moment. So I think this album was written from the point of view of I wanted to enjoy the moment now. And I just enjoy being alive and having kids. We've had quite a few kids during the writing of this album, so that makes you enjoy the moment even more. So I think it was, you know, nature provides so much for happiness, and yet we choose to ignore it, you know.
What a nice guy you seem like. I don't know you, but you're...
Me?
Another thing which is interesting that I mentioned to you again during the videos was that you actually seem like the person who writes the lyrics. Well, a lot of times you interview people in bands, and their songs say one thing, mm-hmm. that they start talking to in between the videos, and they're not... They seem to be faking it, or they're writing something that isn't really from their heart.
Right. Well, I can't... In the end, you can't escape yourself, and I've had to sort of listen to my old songs before and go, oh God, did I say that? Or you have to, you know, you have to live with it. Everything you say, you're gonna have to live with, whether it was a lie or not. You're still gonna have to live with the consequences of the truth or the lie.
You started off, as far as I understand it, in a college band, mm-hmm. in what, 1982, 83?
Yeah, 81.
Oh, even 81.
I've been playing with the drummer since 1971 when I was a little nipper.
Wow. When you initially got into this world of rock and roll, fell into it maybe, mm-hmm. What were your reasons? Was it to get attention? Was it to get chicks? In retrospect.
Chicks. It was, I think, insecurity. You're driven to sort of... I was unemployable. I couldn't take orders from anybody. I still can't, really. And you just have a burning need to be noticed. You know, no, I don't know. It was a mixture of all those things, I'm sure, because I'm a very shy person, but you end up on stage doing something that people think you have to be very extroverted. Mm-hmm. But it's a way of hiding as much as, you know, being somebody that you're not. You can't be, you know, a character. You have to be you, but at the same time, you can hide behind characters. It sounds a very convoluted way of saying, you know, you just get into yourself and hope people take it seriously.
You've built a persona of Cy Curnin from the Fixx, haven't you? Mm-hmm. I mean, when we see you on stage, that's not really you, or is it?
In a way, it's me in my bedroom when nobody's supposed to be watching.
And now you're in a band 10 years later. What keeps you in this band?
Just, I need the release. You know, we all do. After 10 years, we need it more than ever now. It's cathartic. And if I stood in the middle of my room and talked to myself, I'd be a lunatic or a madman. Somebody'd lock me away. You put musicians around you, sane as can be. Mm-hmm. So that's good for all of us. We have that need to release ourselves.
The sound of the new album has changed a lot, I find. It's a lot cleaner sounding, mm-hmm. There's a lot more air, a lot more guitar.
Yeah.
What happened over the last couple of years to make you change?
We just decided, you know, you say less, mean more. And I think the sound followed suit. I started writing guitar songs, and Jamie takes them and makes them sound brilliant because he plays good guitar. And there wasn't really much need to augment things that much other than document the moment, record the moment rather than create a moment in the studio. Mm-hmm. It's a bit contrived when you start to try and make Christmas trees out of just a regular shrub. You know what I mean? So we just have fun with it, and in the end, things are so complicated that you're being honest, I guess, when it's simple.
Mm-hmm. So, what have you been up to in the last years? I mean, we haven't heard from you in quite a while.
Breeding.
Breeding? Mm-hmm. You have kids?
Yeah.
How many?
I have two boys.
How old?
5 and 8 months. Adam, the drummer, is a little girl who's 5 months. So we've had lots of babies. It's nice to have something to come home to. And, you know, it gets you out of yourself. You do things for other reasons. You know, mm-hmm. there's little people looking up at you now.
Now you have to bring home a paycheck. Now you have to bring home a paycheck.
Sure. Absolutely. Well, I'm going to get them out to work as soon as possible. Keep me to the standard of which I've become accustomed to.
Would you want your kids to become musicians?
Whatever they want. I mean, I don't know. My five-year-old really thinks that's what he's going to be. You know, most kids do what they see. And in our house, they see music. So mm-hmm. I think that's what he's going to be. But we'll see. Could be a fireman. Or a policeman, something. Mm-hmm.
So I guess we should play your video, How Much Is Enough?
Please do.
Now this video, from what I understand, you were talking about how the album is indicative of the 1991. This song really seems to be the penultimate of that.
Yeah, I mean, I ask myself the question, how much is enough all the time? Chase, chase, chase. I want to put my feet up now and then. And I think this song was written in that mood, but using things that are going on around me to pinpoint, you know, the restlessness of it. You want to stop still, but you feel restless. Why are you restless? Because you've got modern disease. It's just, you know, where's my soul gone?
I'm guilty of it, absolutely.
Yeah, well,
when I'm sad, I shop.
You're born to shop. Truman's Trooper.
The band is going to be touring in Canada at all?
Yeah, I think May 2nd, May 3rd, they've put some shows in, and I think we'll be coming back later on in the summer. Traveling in the winter, your bag's too big. You've got to carry all these sweaters around.
Right.
Summer tours for us.
That's great.
Yeah.
Well, we look forward to it.
Thank you.
The album is called Ink. This is Cy Curnin, and this is How Much Is Enough on Much.
Woo!
Would you bid $27 to buy? $27 and bid now eat, $29 and bid now $30, $30 now half, $30 and a half, now one, $31 and a half, $32.
How much is enough? Good enough, it's not good enough. Don't complain, but you got it tough. Can't relax, want so much more. Not these won't set you free. Can't you see that time is slipping away? But I gotta say, how much is enough when your soul is empty? How much is enough in the land of plenty? When you have all you want and you still feel nothing at all, how much is
special, many tricks with our minds. That's the